In this short demo video, I will demonstrate SIM activation flow. Once the user has successfully logged into the system, they are navigating to the main landing page with the dashboard. So the top navigation displays the user information along with their imagery, can be logo as well, and the balance available at the moment, along with the logout button. The actual page has the marketing and promotional material section, and the actual dashboard with the analytical charts and graphs and other widgets intended. Please note that these are just the placeholders and not the exhausted list of possible graphs. So this can contain analytics related to SIM inventory management, as well as the various reports related to activation, several breakdowns by the carrier, by the agent, and other visualization and analytics as needed. The menu allows navigation to various modules. So the first one would be the activation module that allows activating single SIM cards, as well as multiple lines and multiple line plans, and also allows porting the number. Also, you can choose to purchase refill options for active plans, and also access shop to buy SIM cards, phones, tablets, various accessories. The tool module section contains access to such tools as a dealer account that would hold the information about the dealer and the financial information and other related settings. Also here we can access order history. We can check statuses for individual SIMs. Have access to the SIM inventory, document library, and the help section. In the reporting module, we can have access to various daily, monthly, weekly reports, and on-demand reports that allow all the analytical reporting, managerial decision making, and so on and so forth. So let's proceed with the activation flow. We choose to activate single SIM, and we are given the option to select the wireless service provider, the carrier. For this demo, we are choosing AT&T. We are taken to the page that displays all the plan options available for this particular carrier. Please note that these are not actual plans and just they are used for the demonstration purposes only. Let's choose to activate the $10 plan. We hit activate now and proceed with filling in all the required information for the activation. That would be the end users, the subscriber first and last name. The SIM number. Since we already have the SIM inventory, there is no need to enter the whole long SIM number. Only last four digits are sufficient. And the random set of numbers for IMEI, and for the demo purposes, let's enter a random zip code and hit activate. If all the data passes verification successfully, the user is notified that the process has started. Since the process can take several minutes, a user can continue working with the portal and get back to checking the SIM card status later on through one of the tools, which is the SIM status tool. This notification also has the direct access to this page. So let's hit check SIM number and enter the last four digits and to search. Here for this demo we have a successful scenario, so we get a confirmation that the SIM card is actually active and we get the to see the number that is associated with the SIM card at the moment. In case of a low balance or zero balance, the flow may have additional steps such as the windows that the screens that would prompt the user to refill the balance to provide the credit card information. So this is a sample of screen. This is an example of what the screen would look like, and the data that would be recorded into this screen. So this is all on the SIM activation.